Hey friends, it's Brian, and I'm going to work on my F-350 restoration project. So on battery cables, the stuff that I needed came in this morning. So we're going to go ahead and cut the insulation off this one. Nice. So now we're going to go ahead and heat shrink it. So we'll do that with the other end. Nice and tight. Here is not nice and tight, but we'll make it nice and tight. That's 7/16, which I don't think I have over here, so let me go get that. All right, so we're to the point where we can turn it over, but it's still not starting. I don't, I don't, I, don't have any ignition switch action, but I'll turn it over for you guys. Should be getting some fuel out of this valve. Alright, so I'm going to fire it over with a little bit of starting fluid. I just want to see it run for a second, and then I'll go back to working on electrical issues. Starter for the moment. So let's, I'm going to drop steering column and look at this ignition switch. What a hot fucking mess in here. Okay, so I'm going to loosen the fuel input bolt or flare, because I want to make sure we're getting fuel up here from the lift pump. Because if we're not, that's one of the problems. But I think we've got something else more basic going on, but I'm not getting any fuel up here. So we'll do this and then... getting fuel. And we're not. Make sure the switch selector is on the right one. Give that a rest. Don't burn the starter out, so we'll give it a couple minutes and go work on the steering column, because I think we got ignition switch issues too. So this bolt and this bolt here are what hold this in. So I'm going to go ahead and get these loose, and let me find some place for the camera to perch, and we'll get that steering column down. All right, a 14 millimeter socket fits these perfectly, so I'm going to go ahead and take them loose. And I'm going to do this the easy way, if there is such a thing. Alright, so what do we got in here? Let's see what this is, and then we'll get it off here. 12 millimeters, so I need to go get a wrench or a ratchet for that. Alright, so that needs a battery. Suspect this switch is fried. It's a, in my opinion, it's a lousy design. It's, I guess it's inaccessible to make it theft resistant, but it's a slide switch, and that's just not a very good design overall. So the question is, do we replace it or do we re-engineer it? I know what I want to do. Can't see anything. All right, so now that we've got this bad boy out, let's see. So, we're just gonna do bad things here. Alright, so the switch is not the problem. See what happens. We'll run around the other side and see if we can start it. No, of course not. I really don't like this. That should be on. see which one's flashing, because I think it's the glow plug relay. Let me just verify that. Definitely the glow plug relay. Switch itself isn't bad, but the rest of this is a hot mess. Turn it over. So, so I'm going to pause here and go do some research on the internet and see what's going on. Okay, so I'm going to do a little testing here. Have to go get something to get in there. Let's see if we can. So what I want to test is that I'm thinking about deleting the ignition switch and replacing it with something else. But before I do that, I want to make sure it works the way I expect it to. And these are some shitty connectors to do by hand. All right. does not. All right, let me go get my meter. All right, so checking for voltage here. I got voltage. No voltage. Go ahead and push the start button. Got voltage. So now we got to figure out where that wire goes and why we don't have power out to the starter. All right, so still not any closer, but one of the things I'm going to go ahead and do is rule out the fuses. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to replace them. One at a time, I'm going to replace every single fuse with a circuit breaker. First I got to go get pliers.
This one
looks good. Let's find the 30. The advantage to these is they are self-resetting, and that's kind of the end of having blown fuses. Is up against the side of the truck, and that makes it really hard to get in and out of here, let alone to see anything. Should have another 20 around here somewhere then. Do not. Let me go to the diagram. Position number 8, which is a 15 amp for the dome lamp. So they had overfused it. Alright. Before, it was also supposed to be a 15 amp. Let's see what we have in here. That is not what that is. So I'm going to pick up troubleshooting where I left off, try and figure out why I don't have power in certain places. So we can trace. We've got power across there now. No power here. That means we're going to have to take everything apart looking for this wire. Probably not today. Well, we only have a foot of access in here. Alright, so the next thing I want to do is I want to test the interlock switch. Do that, I'm just going to climb in from this side and hunt for one of the many tools that I have since misplaced. Yeah, they're all down there. I'll be right back. So what I want to do is test the interlock switch and make sure it's not, the bypass isn't bad. Bypass seems to be okay. Yeah, really. I need that full door open on the other side, and it's I can't get it open with the bus in the way. Damn it. And it makes it really hard to get over there. Alright, so I'm going to go deeper because I got to find this wire. And there's only two ways it's going to get found. Laying upside down underneath the dash is not one of them. Well, it is, but it's not the one I'm going to use. Two up there. Plastic. It. Reach around it. Oh, that's by design. Wow, what a pain in the ass. No wonder they almost gone bankrupt a few times. Mm-hmm.
see the problem. I can't reach the problem. I think it's the speedometer cable. I think I'm not the first one to fault with this.
I'm getting really irritated because I can't reach anything and I can't get to anything. Please take this apart. It looks like it's universal screws. Let me see if I've got a puller. Not getting these all the way in, but it shouldn't require full. A couple of threads should be enough to pull the steering wheel.
if we did. So, switch is just bad. So, time for a new one. Not a big deal. And we can do some other stuff when we're in here with the switch out. So, alright. That's it. Going to be it for tonight. It's going to be a long video. Sorry, not getting a whole lot done. But we are moving forward, believe it or not. I'm going to go ahead and take this switch out.
I don't scream first, because I've got to lower this again. Anyway, 5/16 or a quarter inch for that. Let me get that. So yet again, this has to come down. That's not going to come out through there, so we're going to figure out how this is held on. Need a screwdriver, so let me go get that. Looks like I'm not the first person to have been in here because these are loose. Here. Piece here is broken. Not surprised. So this piece here is broken. actually this piece it holds to. And this is a fairly common thing to have broken. That's gonna go back in because I'm just fucking over it. I don't see what's holding this together, which is really irritating. Almost as irritated as this incessant squeaking behind me. Has to be an assembly. So the question is how to get this apart.